Hello everyone, a very good afternoon to all of you. I hope I'm clearly visible and audible to you people. So I welcome you all for today's session. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev here, and today I'm going to teach you a topic from systemic pathology, from GIT actually, that is peptic ulcer and gastritis. Give me a minute. Let me confirm visibility, audibility is great so I can start the lecture ahead. Yes, so I hope it's working well. So I'm first going to teach you peptic ulcer, right? So what is peptic ulcer? I'm going to teach you peptic ulcer under following headings. These are the headings under which I'm going to discuss the topic peptic ulcer. Okay. So see, what's the definition of the peptic ulcer? Peptic ulcer is a breach in mucosa. You know, stomach have four layers. You know, the complete GIT have four layers. Just a second. So you can see these are the four layers of the GIT. This is mucosa. This is mucosa. Just below the mucosa, there is submucosa. This is submucosa. Just below the submucosa, this is muscularis propria, and this is adventitia or serosa. The outermost is the adventitia or the serosa. So can you see a breach in the mucosa? By breach, I mean the discontinuation. A breach. Can you appreciate a breach here? This is the breach. A breach in mucosa is known as ulcer. That is the definition of ulcer. So what is the ulcer? What is the ulcer? Ulcer is a breach in mucosa of the GIT. A breach in the mucosa of the alimentary canal is known as ulcer. Now, where does it occur? It occurs at two locations. One in the stomach, one in the duodenum. Stomach is known as gastric ulcer. In duodenum, it is known as duodenal ulcer. Both together are known as peptic ulcer. So basically, peptic ulcer are of two types based on the location. One in the stomach, it is known as gastric ulcer. And one in the duodenum, it is known as duodenal ulcer, right? So what are the risk factors for peptic ulcer? So there are two types of stress. One is psychological stress, one is physiological stress. So there are some personalities which are type A personalities who have much stress in life, or whenever we have some exam or any big stress psychologically. So because of the psychological stress, there is increased acid or HCl in the stomach and the duodenum, which will cause breach in the mucosa, and that will cause the ulcer, the breach in the mucosa, that is the ulcer. Whenever there is physiological stress, it is not psychological stress, it is physiological. Physiological stress means shock, trauma, septicemia, severe surgery. In these conditions also, there is increased HCl secretion in the stomach, and that will lead to ulcer, right? Now, two special type of peptic ulcers are there, curling and Cushing. What do you mean by curling? Curling ulcer is in severe burn. Whenever there is severe burn over the whole body or focally, burn is the most painful condition. Due to severe pain, increased HCl secretion is there. In pain, there is increased acidity. Increased HCl secretion in the stomach, so it will lead to ulcer. That is the physiology. This ulcer is known as curling ulcer. The second is the Cushing ulcer. Cushing ulcer is intracranial lesions, that is tumors in the brain, some space occupying lesion in the brain. So this is the brain, you can see. In the brain, some space occupying lesion is present. So it will cause excessive vagal stimulation. It will cause excessive vagal stimulation because of the intracranial lesion. Vagal stimulation will lead to hyperacidity. So here in Cushing ulcer, it is the vagal stimulation which will lead to increased HCl synthesis, or that is the thing. So these are the various risk factors on which maximum MCQs come. So maximum MCQs come, the repeat MCQs is from curling ulcer and Cushing ulcer, from the risk factors of the peptic ulcer. Curling is in burns. So how you will learn? And Cushing is in intracranial lesions. So curling contain R, burn also contain R. So learn like this. You will never forget now. And Cushing is intracranial lesion. So in dono pe, both are from CC. So there is a high confusion, and option mein dono present honge. So please learn. Curling, Cushing pe, repeat MCQ many times in various competitive exams. NEET, PG, FMG, INICT. Okay. So after the risk factors, let me come on the etiology. Why at all ulcer occurs? Okay. Let me form a diagram. This is the esophagus. This is the stomach, and this is the duodenum and the intestine. Right. Now, stomach mein HCl is present. So this is the HCl present in the stomach. Whenever human eat any non-vegetarian, non-veg, that is a meat piece. So this is the meat piece present in the stomach. So does HCl digest the meat piece? It degrade the meat piece or the non-veg? Yes or no? This is meat. This is animal meat. Yes or no? Yes. HCl do the digestion, the degradation of the proteins present in the meat. Now my question is that this is the lining, mucosal lining of the stomach. So why don't HCl degrade its own lining? Why? So there are some protective factors which protect the HCl coming in contact with the mucosa. What are those protective factors? The most important is mucosal lining. This mucosa is lined by a mucosal lining. This mucosal lining, and it contains bicarbonate also. So mucosal and bicarbonate lining and increased blood flow, these are the protective factors. So actually in etiology, there are some damaging factors and some protective factors. What are damaging factors? So see this diagram. Aggressive factors and defensive factors. Aggressive factors are HCl. HCl will cause the breach in the mucosa. Pepsin enzyme will cause the breach in the mucosa. And H. pylori, it is a bacteria. It is a gram-negative coccobacilli. This will cause the breach in the mucosa. But in defensive factors, you have bicarbonate layer, mucus layer, and prostaglandin. Yes, very good, Sushmita. So Nishi, Sushmita, very good. So bicarbonate, mucus, and prostaglandins are the defensive factors. Now, in normal human stomach, both are equal and opposite. The aggressive factors and defensive factors, they are equal and opposite. They cancel each other, right? But whenever, due to any reason, if aggressive factors increases or defensive factor decreases, it will lead to peptic ulcer. So that is the etiology of peptic ulcer. Now, most of the students have this confusion that peptic ulcer is always due to hyperacidity. No, this is not the reason. It may be there, hyperacidity, hyperpepsin, or H. pylori, they increases, it can cause peptic ulcer. But maybe acid is normal, but mucus is less. Acid is normal, but bicarbonate is less, prostaglandin is less. So this will also lead to peptic ulcer, or both can occur together. So aggressive factor increases or defensive factor decreases, it can lead to imbalance. You can see imbalance is there. This is more, this is less. There is imbalance. So imbalance is leading to peptic ulcer. So what is peptic ulcer? It is the imbalance between aggressive and protective factor. Imbalance between the defense and damaging factor. That is aggressive and protective factor. You should know the list of aggressive factor. You should know the list of damaging defensive and protective factors. Now, coming on the types of the peptic ulcer. How many peptic ulcers you know? As I've told you, there are two types. The one which is present in the stomach is gastric. The one which is present in the duodenum is duodenal. So these are the basic two types of peptic ulcer. This is first classification. Another classification is benign and malignant. So another classification, some of them are benign, some of them are malignant. Okay, you can see this one present in the stomach, this one present in the duodenum. So this is gastric ulcer, this is duodenal ulcer, together known as peptic ulcer. Yes or no? Have you got it? What is the most common site in stomach? What is the most common site in duodenum? You tell me. So let me talk about the stomach. Stomach have five portions, right? The most common site in the stomach, okay? The most common site in the stomach is in the first duodenum. Now stomach or duodenum is a more common concern. So duodenum are four times more common as compared to stomach. So duodenal are more common. Duodenal ulcers are more common than gastric ulcers. Overall peptic ulcers may. So duodenal are more common. So what is the most common site in duodenum which is more common? It is in the, now duodenum have three parts, first part, second part, third part, you know it. It is in the first part of the duodenum. It is important MCQ. Number one. First part just after the pyloric canal, right? On the anterior wall of the duodenum. First part ke anterior wall pe. Now what about gastric ulcer? It is less common in gastric ulcer. In gastric ulcer, it is present in pyloric antrum on the lesser curvature and on the posterior wall. So in duodenum, first part of the duodenum may anterior wall pe, stomach may pyloric antrum may posterior wall pe on the lesser curvature. I will show you in the diagram. Can you see this is the first part of the duodenum? Let me mark. This is the duodenum and the first part of the duodenum. So this is the most common location of peptic ulcer. First part of duodenum and first part of duodenum may anterior wall, right anterior here. The second most common location is in the stomach. This is pylorus. It is present in the pylorus on the lesser, this is lesser curvature, you know, on the lesser curvature in the pyloric antrum. But here it is posterior, on the posterior wall. This is the second most common location. Third common location is cardia. Fourth common location. In some persons, we have to do a surgery in which we remove the duodenum. This is duodenum. We are removing the duodenum. So we are opening stomach directly in jejunum. So there is a stoma. This is known as gastrojejunostomy. If this surgery is done, so this is the most common location in these patients where this is the ulcer at gastrojejunostomy stroma. And last, the fifth most common location is the Meckel's diverticulum. So there are five locations. Please learn the sequence. One is in the duodenum. Second is in the gastric stomach. The third in the cardia. The fourth, gastrojejunostomy, stoma. And the fifth is Meckel's diverticulum. Please learn it. Please everyone learn it. In the duodenum, where it is present? It is present in the first part of the duodenum in anterior wall. In the stomach, it is present in pyloric antrum in the posterior wall on lesser curvature. Cardia, ye to learn karna hai. So please learn. This is the sequence. Please learn. Have you got it? Nishi, who else? Sushmita, anyone else who is watching me? So these are the other side. Gastrojejunostomy junction at the cardia, gastrojejunostomy junction and Meckel's diverticulum. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So learn these five. So first three are shown here. This is first, that is duodenum. This is second, pyloric antrum. And this is third, cardia. Fourth, fifth is not shown here. So basically we have two type of peptic ulcer, duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. Duodenal ulcer is more common. Gastric ulcer is less common. So I have to tell you, okay, gross of both of them is same. So gross basically differ whether it is a benign ulcer or a malignant ulcer. So can you see the red color is the ulcer, of course, here. Here also this is the ulcer. Here also this is the ulcer. You have to see the margins of the ulcer. If the margins are punched out, you know, punched out, sharp margins, punched out. Now I cannot show you in the diagram. You have to feel it. So this is the ulcer. Ulcer is depressed and the margins are punched out and sharp. It is benign ulcer. If the margins are big and rolled, can you see rolled? The margins are rolled. It is not sharp. It is smooth margin, rolled over margin. So it is malignant. So learn the term punched out margin in benign ulcer and rolled out margin in malignant ulcer. Again, MCQs, two MCQs. Punched out, benign ulcer, rolled out, malignant ulcer. Have you got it? Okay. Coming on microscopy. Okay. If I cut this ulcer and make a slide of these ulcers, what I will see? So there are four zones. There are four zones in all ulcers. I'm talking about benign, huh? Not malignant. So there are four zones. Can you see? It is very easy. Okay. See, this is mucosa. Everyone see, this is columnar mucosa of the stomach or duodenum. This is also mucosa. This is also mucosa. Please appreciate a breach in mucosa. This is the breach in mucosa. So this is the ulcer. Can you see? Mucosa is discontinuous. So this portion is ulcer number one. Okay. So what are the four layers? The first layer, can you see, this is the first layer, it is necrotic. This region is necrotic, pink color. This region is necrotic. The first zone is necrotic zone. The first zone here is necrotic zone. It forms the floor of the ulcer. So can you see this region? I have marked it with red color. So this is necrotic zone. Necrotic zone is red color. Just below this, after this floor, we have another neutrophil containing region. All of them are neutrophils. Can you see inflammatory cells or neutrophils and few lymphocytes are there? So this zone is known as superficial exudative zone because exudate is present, neutrophils are present. So it contains basically neutrophils, eosinophils, basically. So that is the second zone. The third zone, just below this, we have the third zone. This is the third zone. In the third zone, we have capillaries, abundant capillaries along with inflammation. So this zone is known as granulation tissue. This zone is known as granulation tissue zone. It contains maximum capillaries along with the inflammatory cells. And last zone here you can see, just a second, here you can see fibrosis. Fibrosis means cicatrization. So last zone is cicatrization zone. So what are the four zones? The four zones are in front of you: necrotic zone, exudative zone, granulation tissue zone and cicatrization zone. Give me a thumbs up. So the four zones, question can come in any form. It can be a theory question framed from these zones. What is zone? What is the sequence of zone? What is the floor? Is formed by which zone, right? So that is the thing. Or image-based question can come about the labeling of the zones. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Okay. Let me come on the two type of the ulcers now. I have to explain you these two type of ulcers in detail. So if any patient is coming to you, duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer, both will have acidity in the stomach, in the duodenum, in the GIT. They will have hyperacidity. They will have pain. So, but you have to differentiate whether it is a duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer. The best is due to endoscopy. Endoscopy karke dekh lo ulcer kahan. You do endoscopy and see where is the ulcer. So that is the best thing you can do. But endoscopy is an invasive procedure, a little bit invasive. So clinically, how you will diagnose whether it is a duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer. Okay, see the differences. Duodenal ulcer is more common, four times more common. Gastric ulcer is less common. Duodenal ulcer occurs in young patient, 25 to 30, 50 years of age. Gastric occurs after 60, 60 to 70. So it occurs relatively young, relatively old. Both are more common in males. Both are more common in males. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone, give me a thumbs up. Okay. ठीक है, इटियोलॉजी में दोनों की इटियोलॉजी में एच पायलोरा है एंड अदर फैक्टर्स भी हैं, आई हैव टोल्ड यू द फैक्टर्स। ओके, पैथोजेनेसिस यू कैन लीव, कॉम्प्लिकेशन आई विल कम, या मेन इज क्लिनिकल फीचर्स। प्लीज एवरीवन सी, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू। डियोडिनल अल्सर, गैस्ट्रिक अल्सर, दिस इज डियोडिनल अल्सर, दिस इज गैस्ट्रिक अल्सर। द पेशेंट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, यू हैव टू आस्क द पेशेंट, व्हेन यू ईट फूड पेन इंक्रीजेस और डिक्रीजेस, व्हेन यू ईट फूड pain increases or decreases. If it is duodenal ulcer, on eating food pain decreases, and if it is gastric ulcer, on eating food the pain will increase, right? So pain, the patient is having pain, if you the patient is eating food, it is relief, it is relief. So pain food relief pattern is there in duodenal ulcer. But in gastric ulcer, when the patient take the food, pain will increase. So food pain pattern is there. I'm sorry. The pattern is different in both ulcers. Have you got it? So on eating food, whether the pain is decreasing or increasing. Okay, you want to know the reason behind it. Okay. And one more thing, then I will tell you the reason for both. Night pain. Aadhi raat ko pain hota hai kya? Itna pain ki neend mein se uthna pade. So night pain is common in duodenal ulcer, but no night pain in gastric ulcer. So the reason, actually acid causes the pain. So this is the stomach and this is the duodenum. So one ulcer is in stomach. I don't know what happened. I'm sorry. So one ulcer is in stomach and one ulcer is in the duodenum. This is gastric ulcer. This is duodenal ulcer. So whenever patient eat food, this is food. Whenever patient eat food, what will happen? You tell me what will happen. So whenever patient eat food, HCl ka kya hoga? In the stomach, HCl will be secreted. Yes, HCl will be secreted. So food stimulate HCl secretion. So HCl will cause more pain here. So pain increases on eating food. Now you will say, what about duodenal ulcer? Now some amount of acid, duodenum is basically alkaline. It is intestine, huh? Some amount of acid is always present in the duodenum also. That is basal secretion. But when you eat food, food will neutralize that acid. Food will go there and it will cause alkaline secretion. So acidity decreases on eating food in duodenal ulcer. So whenever you eat food, HCl increases in stomach, so it causes pain, and it neutralizes HCl in the duodenum, so it decreases pain. Have you got the reason? Reason is little bit tricky, but you should understand it. That's why on eating food, pain is in decreased in duodenal ulcer because it neutralizes the acid by causing alkaline secretion. And in gastric ulcer, it increases the food. Same reason with night pain. In the night, you eat the last food, your dinner at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, then you go to sleep. So 8 or 10 hour food free interval is there, food free. But you know, basal secretion of HCl is always there, whether you eat it or do not eat it. Some acid is always there, yes or no? Say you know it now. So this is your gastric ulcer and this is your duodenal ulcer, right? So when basal secretion, you are not eating any food, so basal secretion of HCl will go here and it will get accumulated in the intestine and it will cause pain in the duodenal ulcer, but not in gastric ulcer. Gastric was when 10 hour interval is there, so all the acid will pass in the intestine and it will accumulate in the intestine. There is no food to neutralize it, so it will cause pain in duodenal ulcer but not in gastric ulcer. Again, the reason is tricky, but you have to learn it. If you understood, it's good. If you don't understood the reason, learn it. Learn the first two things. Number three, vomiting kisme zyada hogi और हिमाटेमासिस किसमें ज्यादा होगा, मलीना किसमें ज्यादा होगा. मैं नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, अगेन द सेम डायग्राम, दिस इज स्टमक एंड दिस इज डियोडिनम. सो वन अल्सर इन स्टमक दैट इज गैस्ट्रिक एंड वन इन डियोडिनम दैट इज डियोडिनल अल्सर. सो यू से ब्लीडिंग यहां से भी होगी, ब्लीडिंग यहां से भी होगी. द ब्लीडिंग फ्रॉम हियर विल कम इन वॉमिटिंग एंड द ब्लीडिंग दैट इज नोन एज हिमाटेमासिस एंड ब्लीडिंग फ्रॉम हियर विल कम इन स्टूल्स दैट इज नोन एज मलीना. सो हियर वॉमिट विल कंटेन द ब्लीडिंग. Here, stools will contain the bleeding. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Give me a thumbs up. So these are the two points. So here, vomiting, yahan pe common nahi hai. Vomiting is more common in gastric ulcer. And here, malina is more common. Here, hematemasis is more common. So here, malina means blood in stool. And hematemasis means blood in vomiting. Have you got it? Have you got it? Yes, that is the thing. That is the thing. Loss of weight kis mein hoga? Here, in duodenal ulcer, whenever the patient is eating food, pain is relieved. So patient will eat more food. So here no loss of weight is there. Patient will be in fact overweight, right? In gastric ulcer, whenever bichara patient is eating anything, he is having pain. So he stop eating. He will not eat because he will have pain. So significant weight loss is there in gastric ulcer. Common sense. Here in gastric ulcer, there is no particular choice of the food. He can eat anything and pain is relieved by the food. But gastric ulcer, spicy food, spicy and fried food will aggregate aggressive the pain. So he will choose bland food. He will try to eat bland food without spices, right? Now, in abdomen, there are 9 quadrants. You know, the entire abdomen is divided. This is the abdomen. You divide the entire abdomen into 9 quadrants. You also know the names. Huh? Ye sab aapne kiya hua hai physiology mein, you had professional years. Right? So, where is stomach present and where is duodenum present? In which quadrant? So, let me draw a diagram. I guess this is the esophagus. Stomach is present in this quadrant and duodenum is present in this quadrant. So, stomach ulcer will present here and duodenum ulcer. So, if you palpate and see in which quadrant pain is there. So, if you see, duodenal ulcer have right hypochondrial pain. You can see in the diagram also. This is right hypochondrium. And stomach pain is present in midline in the epigastrium. So, this is epigastrium. Give me a thumbs up. No need to learn. It is visible in the diagram. Give me a thumbs up. There is marked seasonal variation. There is no seasonal variation. Duodenal ulcer is more common in the patient with the, you know what it is written here? Greater anxiety, right? Stress. Or yahan pe laboring group mein hoga. So, that is the thing. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So, the same differences are shown here also. So, I am done. So, reasons I have already told you. So, I am not going on the reason. What is the most common age? Who people are at risk? Periodicity. So, when? Day or night? Pain ka kya hai? In which pain is increasing? In which pain is decreasing? By eating food. And night pain ka kya hai? Vomiting kis mein zyada hai? Hematemesis kis mein zyada hai? Melina kis mein zyada hai? So, read the theory. Read the theory. Weight loss kis mein hai? Deep tenderness kaun se quadrant mein hai? Coming on the complications. The last thing is the complication of the peptic ulcer. There are 3 complications. The most common complication is hemorrhage or bleeding. Ulcers bleed. Ulcers bleed. That is the most common complication. So from duodenal, they bleed from the posterior wall and they cause iron deficiency anemia. So all the bleed either come in the vomiting or it come in the stool. So bleeding will come in the vomiting. So vomiting will be coffee color, coffee ground color vomiting. That is hematemesis. Or bleeding will come in the stool, that is known as melina. So patient ultimately have iron deficiency anemia and duodenal ulcers mein se posterior wall mein se bleed hoga. So both ulcers can bleed, duodenal or gastric. So name the artery from which bleeding is occurring. If there is an ulcer, ulcer is going in the mucosa. From mucosa, it is going deep in the submucosa. Submucosa contains arteries. So arteries will be degenerated from the ulcer. So they will bleed. They will bleed. That is the reason for bleeding. So which artery in duodenal ulcer? Which artery in gastric ulcer? In duodenal ulcer, the name of the artery is gastroduodenal artery. In gastric ulcer, the name of the artery is left gastric artery. Please learn. So please learn. These are the 2 named arteries which bleed in peptic ulcer. Name of the arteries. Again, important MCQs. 2 important MCQs here. Potential MCQs. The second complication is perforation. You know, through and through perforation. Through and through perfo ho gaya. Wall ka. That is the second most common complication. It is an emergency. Perforation se patient tumhare paas aa raha hai. Take the OT. Prepare the OT. Patient ko seedhe OT mein lo, emergency mein. You want to save the patient. That is the most common cause of death in peptic ulcer. Peptic ulcers can rupture. Both can rupture. More common duodenal can rupture. Duodenal ka anterior wall mein rupture hota hai. Bleeding was from posterior wall. And rupture is from anterior wall. You have to learn these walls also. See, this is the ulcer and through ye purpo ho gaya hai, through and through. So it is opening outside in the abdominal cavity. So all the food will come outside the stomach or the duodenum. Give me a thumbs up. The third and the last and the very rare complication, the ulcer. Ulcer is a benign thing. It can convert into malignant. Malignant. So malignant transformation is common. It can occur. It occurs only in gastric ulcer. Only 1% of the gastric ulcer. It do not occur in duodenal. Duodenal ulcer is always benign. Gastric ulcer, only 1% gastric ulcer can convert into malignant. Give me a thumbs up. So what are the 3 complications, you tell me? Most common complication is hemorrhage or bleeding. Second most common complication is perforation. Third most complication is malignant transformation. So MCQs can come on anything. Bleeding ki artery batao. What is the artery for gastric? What is the artery for duodenum? It will lead to iron deficiency anemia. Bleed can come in the stool. It can come in the vomiting. Hematemesis, melina, question kuch bhi aa sakta hai. Perforation is the second most complication. This is the most common. This is second. Perforation occurs mostly in duodenal ulcers on the anterior wall. Anterior wall mein honge and it is an emergency. It is the most common cause of death. It is the most common cause of, death in ulcer. And malignant transformation occurs only in gastric ulcer, 1% gastric ulcer. No duodenal ulcer convert malignant. So question kisi bhi point pe aa sakta hai. First common, second common, rare complication. Learn. Okay. My next point. Very, very interesting. Huh? Very few students understand such depth. Okay, listen. So you can see this is stomach, this is duodenum again, this is an ulcer, maybe in the stomach, maybe in the duodenum, wherever it is present. So what ultimately happen? If it is not converting towards the complication, what will happen? You will say, ma'am, ultimately the ulcer, if you give the treatment, it will heal. If you give the treatment or without treatment also with time, it will heal. If it is not converting towards the complication. There are 2 ways now. Disease either increases or decreases. peptic ulcer is a disease. If it increase, complication will occur. If it decrease, healing will occur. What is healing? Healing is, you know, healing, the steps of healing. The last step of healing is scar formation. So ulcer ki jagah yahan pe scar banega. Yes, yes or no? So ultimate thing is scar formation. Due to the scar formation, there are two complications. Actually, two shapes. Okay, listen. Okay, I will try. It is difficult, but I will try. Let me consider a gastric ulcer only, not duodenal. So this is a gastric ulcer. So how healing takes place? Now there are two possibilities ki healing kaisa ho raha hai. Healing can take place in this direction or in this direction. Pehle is direction mein lete hain. This one. So, you know, scar formation. Scar mein shrinkage hota hai. Contracture. The term is contracture. So due to contracture, the shape, yahan pe contracture karo. Do the contracture in this direction. So what will be the shape of stomach then? Let me draw. The shape of the stomach will be like this. Okay. The shape. So this portion is contracted. Let me draw. This portion is contracted. Due to the contracture, ye deep ho gaya. Yes or no? Give me thumbs up. Rehan, Nishi, Sushmita. This portion is contracted. So this. It is known as teapot. I will show you the diagram. Can you see? It is like a teapot. Teapot stomach. And if the contracture is taking place in this direction. So what will happen? The shape of the stomach in that direction. In that case, kaisa ho jayega? So this is the stomach. This is dilated over here. And again contracted and again dilated. So it is like a glass. You know, there is a glass known as hourglass. It is used for drinking beer, whiskey. It is there in the bars. You may have seen this shape. It is known as hourglass. This is teapot. So there are two shapes of the stomach known as teapot and hourglass. Depending contracture, aapka, it is occurring in which direction? In longitudinal or in transverse? That is my point. So there are two. Teapot stomach. It is teapot due to the longitudinal shortening. Can you see? The stomach converted into teapot. Teapot. From the normal shape, it got. So here is the ulcer. So it got contracted. So looking like a teapot. Yes or no? It is a teapot. You know, teapot shape. Give me a thumbs up. Fancy term. And the second is hourglass due to the contraction in transverse direction. So this is the stomach. You can see it is looking like a glass. I don't have a diagram for this glass. You know, you may have seen this glass in the bars. Right? So this is the shape of this glass. It is like this. So it is an hourglass. Hourglass. So that is teapot and hourglass. Teapot, hourglass appearance of the stomach. So due to the contraction, healing, this is taking place. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. Last two things. I have already taught you Cushing ulcer. It is seen in intracranial lesions due to raised ICT. And curling ulcer, it is seen in burns. So Cushing, curling. So we are done. I guess I am done with the two types of the ulcers. Duodenal ulcer, gastric ulcer. Okay, tell me the most common location. It is in first part of the duodenum in the anterior wall. It is along the lesser curvature in the pyloric entrance in the posterior wall. Incidence, this is more common, this is less common. Age, 25 to 50, 60 to 70. Both are more common in male as compared to female. Etiology, here mainly H. pylori. And here, H. pylori ho bhi sakta hai, but less stronger association. Okay, here pain after food is decreased, here pain after food increases. Night pain and melena are common. No night pain, but hematemesis is common. No vomiting, no weight loss. Vomiting and weight loss are common. No malignant change. One person can undergo malignant change. Is this easy? Kya batao? So on all points, there are questions. Please learn this difference ka table. The next are the investigations. What investigations you will offer to the patient? There are three investigations. One is screening test. One is gold standard. One is specific investigation. Specific investigation. So what is screening test? Screening test is known as urea breath test. What is urea breath test? Does anyone know what is urea breath test? Okay. So this is the stomach. Now 90% cases, stomach and duodenum. The duodenal ulcer or peptic ulcer, 90% times they are associated with H. pylori. Just suppose this is the ulcer or this is the ulcer and H. pylori is present inside them. This is the organism, bacteria H. pylori. Right. Now whether H. pylori is present or not present, how I will know? Just a second. Okay, yeah, I can see. Okay, so how I will know whether H. pylori? So the best is to take a biopsy. So biopsy is difficult to take now. Biopsy is painful, invasive procedure. Apart from biopsy, what I can do? I can do urea breath test. Okay, I will give a glass of urea to this person and ask him to drink the urea. So he will drink urea. Yeah, the most important thing, this urea contains carbon, which is radioactive carbon, C14 carbon. Urea, I don't know the formula for urea, the chemical formula, but it contains carbon, definitely. And the carbon here in urea is radioactive. I'm asking the person to drinking it. So patient is drinking. So this radioactive carbon, urea containing, it is going in the stomach. It is going in the stomach and the duodenum. If H. pylori is present, this H. pylori contains an enzyme known as urease. Otherwise, urease is not present in our gut. Urease is present in our gut only if H. pylori is present. H. pylori contains urease. Urease will act on this urea. And urea will split by the urease into CO2 plus H2O. Right? Urease will split the urea into CO2. H2O to aage chala jayega and it will be excreted in the feces. Right? H2O. What about CO2? This CO2 contains carbon which is radioactive. Because urea here contains carbon of radioactive. This CO2 is exhaled in the breath. Give me a thumbs up. So I am inhaling C and I am exhaling. In the exhalation, I take out carbon dioxide. So there is an instrument known as breath analyzer. It is like a small instrument. You give this instrument to the patient and ask, isme exhale karo. So patient will inhale after drinking urea. After 5-10 minutes, patient will inhale and exhale. Exhale in the breath analyzer. And breath analyzer will show, isme radioactivity hai ki nahin. If it is has radioactivity, means it has carbon. It has CO2, means urease is present. So this is a simple test, urea breath test. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So that is the thing. So that is the principle. So here you can see in urea breath test, a radioactive labeled urea is given and it will convert into water and carbon dioxide. Urea contains C14. So CO2 which is formed is C14. And put a breath analyzer. If H. pylori is present, then urease is present. That will split the urea and CO2 will come in the breath. So it will give an indication. That is urea. So there is no pain, no injection, no blood test, nothing. Simply ask the patient to drink urea and apply breath analyzer. That's it. Done. What is the gold standard test? Gold standard test is to take the biopsy. Biopsy lelo. On the biopsy, see H. pylori. This is the organism. Can you see here? Okay, let me mark. The small rod shaped organisms you can see. This is mucosal cell. Mucosal cell ke bahar hai ye. So, there is a special stain for them known as Bardenstarrii. Again, a very important MCQ. Bardenstarrii is the special stain with stain H. pylori. Right? And specific investigation, do the culture. Culture for H. pylori is Q medium. Ye aapne microbiology mein padha hoga. So, that is the thing. Give me a thumbs up. What is the treatment in KDT, in pharmacology? You may have studied the treatment. It is triple drug therapy. We give three drugs together. What are the three drugs? One is PPI. One is PPI. That is aniprazole. And usually it is lansoprazole. One is clarithromycin. And one is metronidazole. That is an anti-parasitic drug for 2 weeks. So that is triple therapy. There is quadruple therapy. There are various regimens. Triple therapy may be. LCA, which I have told you. One is PPI. One is amoxicillin. One is clarithromycin. One is another. आपको लैंसोप्राजोल की जगह दूसरा प्राजोल दे रहे हैं ओमेप्राजोल अमोक्सिसिलिन इज सेम लेकिन क्लारिथ्रोमाइसिन की जगह मेट्रोनिडाजोल है सो देयर आर वेरियस रेजिमेंस सो आई एम डन विद पेप्टिक अल्सर द कंप्लीट टॉपिक इज डन इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट प्लीज लेट मी नो सो यू नो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द पेप्टिक अल्सर यू नो व्हाट आर द रिस्क फैक्टर्स ऑफ द पेप्टिक अल्सर व्हाट इज द इटियोलॉजी दैट इज द टू टाइप ऑफ फैक्टर्स एग्रेसिव फैक्टर्स एंड डिफेंसिव एग्रेसिव इंक्रीजेस डिफेंसिव डिक्रीजेस The two types, gastric and duodenal, the difference between them, the clinical features difference between them. What is the site? Most common site, second most common site, gross, the two type of ulcer, punched out ulcer and punched out margin and rolled out margin. Microscopy mein four zones. Complication, three complications, bleeding, perforation and malignant transformation. Investigation mein screening, gold standard and diagnostic. Treatment mein triple therapy. So any question can come in your exam. So please, it is a very important topic. The next topic here, which I'm going to take is gastritis. Gastritis is inflammation. Itis. What is itis? Itis is inflammation. Inflammation of the gastric mucosa is known as gastritis. Give me a thumbs up. Now here ulcer nahi hai. Inflammation. Inflammation. Inflammation is of two types, acute and chronic. Acute mein neutrophil aayenge, chronic mein lymphocyte aayenge. So acute and chronic. In acute, it is the acute mucosal injury. There is neutrophils. So acute, it is most common cause is NSAID. If you take too much painkiller, that will cause acute injury. And that is, we can see neutrophils. See the entire, can you see the four layers? This is mucosa. Just below the mucosa, this is entire submucosa. In the entire submucosa, glands are there. But if you zoom it out, between the glands, these all are neutrophils. The entire wall is filled with the neutrophils. That is acute. Acute is not important. More important here is chronic. Now chronic ka most common cause there are two type of chronic so two causes are there acute ka ek hi cause hai most common NSAID एक्यूट का, एक्यूट का मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज है एनसेट, अदर्स आर देयर बट मेन इज एनसेट, राइट? एक्यूट. क्रॉनिक इज ऑफ टू टाइप. क्रॉनिक इज टाइप ए, टाइप बी. ए बी इज द मिक्स टाइप, टाइप ए बी. ए फॉर ऑटो इम्यून, बी फॉर बैक्टीरिया. विच बैक्टीरिया? एच पायलोरा. सो टू कॉजेज ऑफ द क्रॉनिक, वन इज एच पायलोरा, वन इज ऑटो इम्यून. वन इज एच पायलोरा, वन इज ऑटो इम्यून. एच पायलोरा इज द कॉज ऑफ बी टाइप, बी फॉर बैक्टीरिया, एंड ऑटो इम्यूनिटी इज द कॉज ऑफ ए टाइप. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. सो टू टाइप्स ए बी, एंड सो लेट मी टीच यू द टू टाइप्स एंड दैट्स इट. नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स. सो टाइप ए, लेट मी स्टार्ट टाइप ए. सो वॉट इज हैपनिंग हियर, यू नो यू हैव स्टमक. In the stomach, there are various types of cells. One of the cell is parietal cell. One of the cell is parietal cell. There are chief cells, zymogen cell. One of the cell is parietal cell. Parietal cells secrete two things in the lumen. One is HCl and one is, क्या कहते हैं उसको? Vitamin B12 के absorption के लिए, what do you need? Vitamin B12 के, write it down ना, I'm just skipping the name. For vitamin B12 absorption, you require, just a second, let me see. Okay. Intrinsic factor. Okay, so let me draw the diagram again. So what is actually happening? Listen here. So this is your stomach. This is your parietal cell. Parietal cells secrete two things in the stomach. One is HCl and one is intrinsic factor, which is required for vitamin B12 absorption. Right? Now body will form antibodies against parietal cell, against own cell. It is an autoimmune disease. So body is forming antibodies against stomach ka ek parietal cell. So parietal cell is destroyed. So first thing, gastric atrophy is there. Jahan jahan parietal cell hai, that is destroyed. Parietal cells, jahan jahan pe bhi hai, that is destroyed. So gastric atrophy is a feature. Number one, learn it. Gastric atrophy. Now this is lost. So both of this will be lost. So patient will have achlorhydria. Say yes or no. Achlorhydria. So that is, achlorhydria means less HCl. Hypochlorhydria or achlor, HCl is absent. And intrinsic factor is absent. So patient will have anemia. Vitamin B12 deficiency is there. Vitamin B12 deficiency ki wajah se anemia is pernicious anemia. So patient will have pernicious or megaloblastic anemia. So these are the three features of type A. Give me a thumbs up. What is the cause? Autoimmunity. So antibodies are formed against which cell? Parietal cell. So give me the thumbs up. Autoantibodies are formed against parietal cell. Parietal cells are depleted. It will lead to gastric atrophy. Intrinsic factor ki deficiency hai, to pernicious anemia hoga. Or HCl nahi hai, to hypochlorhydria or achlorhydria hoga. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. That is type A. Type A. Type A mein HCl kam hai. HCl कम है तो फीडबैक से गैस्ट्रिन ज्यादा है. इफ देयर इज लेस HCl और नो HCl, फीडबैक से गैस्ट्रिन विल बी मोर इन द ब्लड बिकॉज ऑफ द फीडबैक मैकेनिज्म, राइट? एंड देयर इज परनीशियस एनीमिया एंड देयर इज गैस्ट्रिक एट्रोफी. सो दीज आर द फीचर्स ऑफ टाइप ए. लेट मी टॉक अबाउट टाइप बी. इन टाइप बी देयर इज नो ऑटोइम्यूनिटी. एच पायलोरा इज कमिंग इन द स्टमक. ओके, सो अगेन आई विल ड्रॉ अ स्टमक. दिस इज द स्टमक. दीज आर द सेल्स ऑफ द स्टमक, वेरियस सेल्स. हियर दे आर नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय एनी एंटीबॉडी. Actually, H. pylori is coming inside and that is infecting the cell. So, H. pylori causing hypersecretion. Yahan pe HCl ka hypersecretion hoga from the parietal cell. So, HCl is more. And HCl is the aggressive factor. That is a damaging factor. More HCl will cause breach in the mucosa. So, they will have peptic ulcer as a consequence. So, type A have pernicious anemia, gastric atrophy, achlorhydria and hypergastrinemia. Type B have peptic ulcer, more HCl. HCl is more, so gastrin is less. So HCl or gastrin ka level alag alag hai. Have you got it? I'm done. So this is type A, this is type B. A for autoimmune, B for bacteria. Bacteria is H. pylori, right? So here, autoimmune, autoantibodies are formed against which cell? Tell the cell, it is parietal cell, pehla question. Parietal cell secrete two things, HCl, it is gone. And intrinsic factor, it is gone. Parietal cells are gone. So three consequences are there. What are the three consequences? Who will tell me? Parietal cells are gone, so gastric atrophy. HCl is gone, so achlorhydria or hypochlorhydria. Hypochlor. Or intrinsic factor is gone, so pernicious anemia. Give me a thumbs up. And since HCl is less, it will lead to hypergastrinemia. So that is the consequence. Here, bacteria will come in the stomach and it will cause hypersecretion of the HCl. So HCl is more, so gastrin is less. And hypersecretion will lead to peptic ulcer. So, yahan pe peptic ulcer is the consequence. Yahan pe peptic ulcer nahi hoga, kyunki HCl kam hai. Give me a thumbs up, I tried my best. And here HCl or gastrin ka level dekho. Yahan pe HCl is more, HCl is less, gastrin is more. Yahan pe HCl is more, gastrin is less. So, that is the best thing I can teach you. One more thing, what is the most common site of both of them? Type A, type B, stomach mein kahan hote hain? Dono stomach mein hote hain. So, this is the stomach. What are the 5 portions of the stomach? So, one is fundus. One is cardia, one is body, one is एंट्रम एंड वन इज पाइलोरस, एफ सी बी ए पी, दीज आर द फाइव पोर्शंस यू नो. कहां पे होते हैं, ए कहां पे होगा, बी कहां पे होगा? नो, उल्टा है. ए अकर्स इन बी, दिस इज टाइप ए, दिस इज टाइप बी. ए अकर्स इन बॉडी, बी ए बी में होगा, एंड बी अकर्स इन एंट्रम, बी अकर्स इन एंट्रम. इससे इजी मैं नहीं पढ़ा सकती. सो बी अकर्स इन ए अकर्स इन बी, लर्न लाइक दैट. सो ए अकर्स इन बॉडी, बी अकर्स इन एंट्रम. इस पे भी बहुत कॉमन एमसीक्यू है, वेरी कॉमनली आस्क्ड. नाउ यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट. ए अकर्स इन बी, बी अकर्स इन ए. ए फॉर ऑटोइम्यून, बी फॉर बैक्टीरिया. दैट्स इट, दैट्स इट. सो आई एम डन. सो हियर दिस इज बी, हियर ए विल अकर, दिस इज ए, हियर बी विल अकर. सो आई एम डन विद दैट. सो टाइप ए बी उसके अलावा है. सो देर आर टू टाइप्स, यू कैन सी द टू टाइप्स हियर. दिस इज ए ऑटोइम्यून, दिस इज बैक्टीरिया बी. सी द लोकेशन, ए A occurs in B and B occurs in A, right? So here autoantibodies are formed, here no autoantibodies are formed, here peptic ulcer is there, here atrophy, pernicious anemia is there. So here gastrin is decreased, here it is increased, here acid is increased, here it is decreased. So ye sari cheeze, I hope you got it. So histology of gastritis is not very important, these two types were important. So I hope I have to stop here. I am done with the two topics, peptic ulcer and gastritis, that were planned for today. I hope you have learned it. So the time is over, so I have to stop here. Thank you very much for being with me. If you like the lecture, write down in the comment box. If you have any suggestion, feedback, don't forget to write it in the feedback box. Any other topic you want from my side, please write it down. Next class will be tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. in the morning. Daily 9 to 10, I take classes on the YouTube. So tomorrow also on Future Doctor YouTube channel of an academy, I'm having a lecture. For detailed lecture, what you can do, you can install an Academy app from the learners, from the Play Store, and go to NEET PG category. In NEET PG category, search my name, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. You will find my profile link. Please follow it. If you have not followed yet, you are doing a big mistake. You will get a list of recordings, free recordings taken by me. More than 200, 300 recordings are available. The only thing you have to use a code to unlock it is Sachdev10. S-A-C-H-D-E-V, Sachdev10 is the code that you have to use to unlock it. So on Unacademy, we have two types of paid subscription. One is Plus, one is Iconic. In Plus, you will get access to live and recorded lectures of Unacademy from India's top educators. In Iconic, along with Unacademy, you will get access to PrepTeller also. So better to go with Iconic if you are thinking of taking a paid subscription. These are the features you will get access once you take the subscription. These are the batches from the top educators. You will be eligible for attending lectures in all these batches. These are the current offers running on the platform. And the last thing, what you can do, you can check the various plans on Unacademy Learners app. The plans for the Plus along with their prices, the plans for the Iconic along with their prices. Longer the plan, cheaper it is. So if you are a first prof, second prof, go with a longer plan. If you are a final year, go with a shorter plan. Whatever plan suits to you, fits to you, please purchase it. Please take the subscription. It will be very beneficial for you. And before payment, please apply the code for discount. That is my surname, Sachdev, S-A-C-H-D-E-V, Sachdev10 is the code. You will get straightforward 10% discount if you apply this code before payment. Thank you very much and see you all tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. Bye-bye.